Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is Tech Thursday, of course, and after a few requests, I have decided I'm going to show you how I make my little subscribe button with the bell notification that you see on most YouTubers' channels, like this one here. So let's go into the on-screen view and let's step right into it. It'll be a step-by-step guide of even how to put it into your video and everything. We will be using Keynote and we will be using Final Cut Pro. You can also use iMovie for this, and you can also do it on your iPad or on your MacBook or iMac. So let's step into it. So let's just open up Keynote. Okay, and we're going to create a new document. So we can just select the black one, that's the one I always use. Then what we're going to do, we're going to click on document up the top right here. We are going to then change it to widescreen because that is the size of your video. Now what I like to do here, I like to create it on a green screen because then I just put a key in it in Final Cut Pro, which I'll also show you, and that will make it a little bit easier to just place over the top of the video. So, depends where you want it, depends how big you want it. You can always change the size and things. But first we'll change the background to just lime green. It's hideous, I know, but this is how it's done. All right, so let's make one. So you want the subscribe button and you want the bell and you also want a pointer. So let's go subscribe, PNG, go to images. And we want transparent background. And then you just select one that you like. So you know that if it has these little gray squares in the background, that means it's on a transparent background. Let me see if I can get one that shows more. See how it has those? That means it's on a transparent background. So let's use this one. So we're just gonna drag and drop it in here. Then we'll go bell icon PNG. So then you just select one you like. We're gonna go transparent background. Yep, let's do that one. Okay. So we've got our bell icon and we've got our subscribe button and we're gonna wanna make them smaller because say this is your whole screen, you only want it sort of appearing in the bottom right or the bottom left, top left. If you want it in the middle, you can. Like I said, it's really personal choice here. I'd probably go a bit of a brighter bell than this, just in case your video is a bit dark. So let's change bells. Okay, so in Keynote, I add the effects. Then in Final Cut Pro, or you can use iMovie, I add the sound effects. So let's start with them appearing. So we'll click on Animate, Build an Effect. We'll add a built-in effect of... So you can really select any ones you like. So the dissolve is nice. I'll show you how to change this so it automatically does it as well. So we'll need a pointer PNG as well. So let's just go for one of these. Perfect, got transparent background. Okay, so we're gonna add an effect for this one. We are going to, okay, so for this one, you're gonna want it to move in. So you're gonna click move in. We're gonna go from bottom to top. So I'm gonna preview that. I want it to go a little bit quicker than that. So you just change the seconds here, preview that again. Perfect. So then we click on move. We select it to move over to this one here, and then we can do a build out, add an effect. And what I did for mine, which I kind of liked, I do a confetti look, but they all confetti off together, so we'll go confetti there. We're going to change the order these happen in just a moment. I'm just adding all my effects for now. Okay, and then to get the clicking sort of effect, let's preview this. So as you can see, I changed the pulse to 1 and it's just, I left the scale on as it is. We're gonna add another action. We're gonna add another pulse, and you want to move this one down here for when it goes over the bell icon. We want to change those pulses to 1. So now what it's going to look like is pulse. Now, also what you're going to do here, as you have the build order up here, you're going to change that to after transition. You can change this one to with build 1, because you want those two appearing together. You're going to change after build 2, so this will make it happen all automatically for you. Okay, so let's preview this. So they appear, clicker comes up, clicks the first one, clicks the second one, and then disappears. Now the other thing we're going to do is we're going to get both of these here. We're going to create a build out. We're also going to use the confetti one with this one as well. That one's going to go with build 7, because you want it all disappearing together, and you want this one with build 7 as well. So now what you've got here is this. So what that is appear, swipe up, click, click, everything disappears. So I like the confetti look. You can play around with the different looks. There's heaps of them. Okay, so now that we've done that, we want to add our sound effects to it. So you can't add sound effects in Keynote, as far as I know. If you can, please, someone let me know. File, export to, we're going to export it as a movie. Self-playing, we're going to go 180p, and you know, next. We're going to export it into there. So it's currently exporting, as you can see. Now, while we're waiting for that to export, I'm going to open up Final Cut Pro here. Now, I like Final Cut Pro because it comes with a lot of sound effects. You can use a lot of different things you can use. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to place this in the timeline. So what we've got here is this. Click, click, disappear. So now let's add in our sound effects for that. So let's zoom right in here. Let's go to sounds. Now go to sound effects. Okay, so now let's select our sound effects. Okay, so let's just go to click, and we'll find where it pulses. So you want to make sure it lines up. Okay, and you can even add out effect. You can even just make it like a little cork sound. Like I said, I'm only doing this just to show you sort of what we do. So then we've got this. You want to go File, Share, Master File. And we're just going to go Untitled, doesn't matter. We'll call it Done so I know the difference. Okay, so that's currently exporting. So now let's just go to one of my previously made videos, and I'm just going to show you how I'd add it over the top. So let's go to my HelloFresh video. It's already got the subscribe buttons, obviously. But like I said, I'm just want to show you how we add it over the top here. So then I find it in my folder, we put it over the top, and obviously it's going to overlay everything. We're going to go to the effects browser, we're going to go to keying, we're going to go to Kia, we're going to pop that over the top, and then what you've got here is this. Ready?
They sent it to the wrong address. I update the address 3 times because we're a unit, 2/3.
Done. Easy done. And that took me a whole 15 minutes to do total. I've cut out obviously some bits while I was waiting for things to load and things, but yeah, that's all it took me is 15 minutes.
Thanks for watching my little tutorial, guys. I hope this was really helpful to you all, and I hope to see subscribe buttons on all of your channels in all of your videos. As usual, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you all next time. Bye.
Yo, my name is Oprah and this is my spot. Take a seat and don't worry, cause I ain't a big shot. I was thinking we could make a little tribe, but that only works if y'all subscribe.